Goeiemôre aan elkeen wat saam met ons ingeskakel is. Dit voel baie vreemd. En ons is in baie vreemde en unieke omstandighede. Ek het daarom 'n vroukie wat ek voor kan preek. En verder is dit 'n klomp leesstoele. We would like to welcome each one of you joining us on live stream. It is our prayer that the Lord would bless us. Definitely we are in unique circumstances. We've never been here. We've never experienced something like this, and we can't even say where we are going. Our future in the world is so unsure. And indeed times that you and I should cling to the Lord. This lockdown is going to cause one of two things for you and me. It's either going to drive us away from God or it is going to bring us closer. And it is up to you and me to decide which one of the two it will be. Ons bevind ons in 'n tyd wat u en ek die voorreg het, die geleentheid het en definitief die tyd het om nader aan die Here te kom. Niemand gaan kan sê maar ek het nie die tyd gehad of daar was nie geleentheid nie, want ons het dit. En ek wil u aanmoedig en uitnooi om in hierdie tyd die Here te soek. En as jy nie lus het nie, want dit gebeur dat ons nie lus het nie, dan kan jy vra, Here, maak my lus. Kom gee van my, Here, my hart te honger na jy, dat ek jy sal soek en meer sal soek. En mag dit 'n tyd wees waarin elke kind van die Here nader kom. Ons word uitgedaag om te bid dat die virus moet weggaan. We are challenged to pray that this virus would go away. And I'm not so sure that this is what God wants. If I read Matthew 24 and I find a list of things Jesus told us, what would happen in the end of days before He's coming, we find that one of the things on the list is also pestilences, which is also translated as diseases. Matthew 24. We read in verse 6 or verse 7, for nation will rise against nation and kingdom against kingdom, and there will be famines and pestilences and earthquakes in different places, and all these things, Jesus said, is only the beginning of the end. I'm sharing with you a word this morning that might seem negative, but I would trust the Lord that He would use this negative thought of death to inspire and encourage you and me to fix our lives with God. And if I'm not at the right place and not in the right relationship with God, then this is the time to seek God. Mag die Here vereen vir my as ons in hierdie tyd dalk bevrees raak, bang raak, en ek wonder of ek een van die statistieke gaan word, wat tot sterwe gaan kom, dat vanmôre se woord vir u nie negatief sal wees nie, maar dat dit u na die Here toe sal dryf. Kom ons bid saam. Hemelvader, ons dank u uit ons harte uit. Ons het die geleentheid, ons het die tegnologie, om u woord vanmôre te deel, en ons dank u daarvoor. Ons dank u vir elkeen wat ingeskakel is, en ek wil bid, Here, u wat ons harte ken, u wat ons harte kan deursoek, dat u asseblief persoonlik met ons deur u woord sal kom praat. Lord, it is you who know us in the deepest of our hearts. You know our fears. You might know our sorrow. You might know us. You know our circumstances. And I pray, Lord, that you would reach us through your word this morning, that you would touch our hearts. Come and speak to us through your word. Lord, give us the privilege to hear your voice. We pray that in Jesus' name. Amen. Ons wil net 'n paar afkondigings doen, of net vir u sê wat aangaan. Ons gaan vanavond op ons gesamentlike kerkblad, dit is CG Kerk in SA, verder luister na Monty Brits, wat die woord vir ons daar bedien. Woensdag aand om 7 uur gaan ons Bybelstudie ook lewend uitsaai. U is welkom om saam met ons in te skakel. As daar iemand is wat 'n vraag het, vra dit asseblief. Wednesday evening we have Bible study, and we would like to encourage anyone to send us a question. Any question out of God's word, which you don't know the answer of, We would like to discuss something that someone wants to know. So please let me know if there's a question for Wednesday evening, 7 o'clock, and you are welcome to join us. We are living in challenging times also around finances, not only our congregation, throughout the world, because we are in lockdown. The people who know me and know our congregation would know we don't talk about money often. Actually, we hardly ever talk about money. But I'd like to mention to you, if there's a way you can contribute, and we're talking to the congregation, ons praat met die gemeentelede, as jy bydra wil gee, ek het die bankbesonderhede op die webtuiste, jy sal dit sien op die foto voorop van ons kerkgebou, het ek ons bankbesonderhede aangebring, net soos wat die Here vir u lei. En ons vertrou dat die Here dan ook in hierdie tyd vir ons sal voorsien, en op 'n ander manier dalk ons finansies vir ons sal inbring. Ons gaan een lied saam sing nou, ek gaan nou vanmorgen alleen moet sing, maar ons nooi vir ons saam met my te sing, een baie bekende lied. We are going to start with a very familiar song. I'm going to have to sing it alone, but I'm encouraging you to sing along with me there in your home, a song that tells us of Jesus and His grace. I will be stepping out of the light, but please join me in singing this song, Jesus Groot Behandel. We're going to sing the Afrikaans, the English, and then the Afrikaans again. To invite you to open God's word at Philippians chapter 2. Philippians chapter 2, Paul is writing out of prison. And luckily I have a secretary here telling me not chapter 2, chapter 1. Philippians chapter 1, Philippense hoofstuk 1, Paulus is besig om uit die tronk uit met die gemeente te praat oor sy omstandighede, en ons kan altyd by Paulus leer dat hy maak nie saak waar hy was, wat hy ondervind het of beleef het nie, altyd homself in die Here verbly het en altyd verstaan het dat die Here met alles wat gebeur een doel het. It was Paul telling us and actually living what he was preaching. Realizing that it does not matter what my circumstances are, God always has a purpose for the child of God. And we need to notice, does not matter what God allow in our lives, even sitting in jail, even going through tremendous persecution, always realizing it would not separate me from God. In fact, it brings me closer to God. But here in chapter 1 of Philippians, he talks to us about dying. I think a subject that is relevant in the times we find ourselves. As Paulus in 1 Philippense 1 praat oor die dood en die feit dat ek tot sterwe moet kom, want dit is 'n feit, dan dink ek, is dit relevant vir die tyd waarin ons lewe en die omstandighede waarin ons bevind. Ons vind ons te midde van die COVID-19 virus. En net gister het ons gehoor dat net in Italië alleen is by die 900 mense oorlede, net in een dag. En in Spanje trek hulle hier by die 800 per dag. En ek bevind ons in 'n land waar ons getalle stadig en stadig groei, en ek dink ons kan vir mekaar sê, ons is op pad soontoe. Sonder om negatief te wees, sonder om doemprofeet te wees, statistieke sê vir ons, ons gaan ons binnekort in 'n posisie vind waar mense rondom ons in die duisende gaan sterwe. Die dood was dalk nog nooit so werklik soos wat dit in die tyd is waarin ons lewe nie. Maar ek wil die negatiewe gedagte van dood wil ek omdraai en saam met Paulus dit positief maak. The word this morning takes this tremendous negative thought of death. The subject we don't like talking about. And it changes it around into something actually amazing, into a positive thought. And this morning's question is a very strange question. Are you also looking forward to dying? Hoe klink hierdie baie vreemde vraag van môre? Dis ons gedagte wat die Heer op my hart gelê het. Sien jy ook uit na die dood? I know when you talk about death, there are many people who tell you, well, let's change the subject. Let's not talk about this. Let's rather try and lift one another up. 'N onderwerp wat baie vinnig in 'n ander rigting gestuur word wanneer mense oor die dood praat. Want ons sê vir mekaar, ons wil nie oor dood praat nie, dis negatief. Paulus praat oor die dood en hy's opgewonde daaroor. As 'n mens vir iemand sou sê, as hulle jou vra, is jy nie bang vir die virus, is jy nie ook angsbevange dat dit jou dalk kan tref nie, en jy antwoord vir iemand, weet jy, as jy sou doodgaan, of as ek sou doodgaan van 'n virus, is dit nie wonderlik nie, want dan gaan ek hemel toe, dan kry jy so 'n bietjie skeptisisme. People are skeptic when you answer positive about death. And if someone should ask you, aren't you afraid that you would also get the virus, and your answer would be positive, then people find it strange. In the start, before we read, I want to tell you if death and the fact of death is a fearful fact for you. As die dood jou bang maak, en 'n gedagte van vrees hier in jou binneste lewend maak, dan wil ek hê jy moet vanmôre jou hart oopstel vir die woord van die Here en wat die Here in sy woord sê oor die dood, sodat jy ook wanneer jy oor die dood praat of aan die dood dink soos 'n Paulus, daaroor opgewonde kan wees. Ek het die vraag gevra, sien jy ook uit na die dood? Kom ons lees Filippense 1 vanaf vers 18. Philippians 1 from verse 18, I'm going to read it in Afrikaans. It is Paul writing out of the prison, And telling them it doesn't matter if I'm in prison, because even here in prison, I've got the opportunity to testify. Paulus wat sê, dit maak nie saak of ek in die tronk sit nie, want ek kan nog steeds deur my lewe Christus se naam groot maak. En hy begin vers 18. Maar wat maak dit in alle geval op allerlei wyse, of dit onderskyn of in waarheid is, word Christus verkondig en hierin verbly ek my en sal ek my ook verbly. Vers 19, vers 19, want ek weet dat dit deur julle gebed en ondersteuning van die Gees van Jesus Christus my tot heil sal strek. Volgens my reikhalsende verwagting en hoop dat ek in niks beskaam sal word nie, maar dat Christus met alle vrymoedigheid, soos altyd so ook nou, groot gemaak sal word in my liggaam, of dit deur die lewe of deur die dood is. Paul telling us that it doesn't matter if I'm living or I'm dying, because while living or even in dying, God can glorify himself through me. And then he comes to this subject of dying. Verse 21. Vir my is die lewe Christus en die sterwe wins. Maar as ek in die vlees moet lewe, dan beteken dit vir my vrugbare arbeid. En wat ek sal kies, weet ek nie. Want ek word van weerskante gedring, ek het 'n verlange om heen te gaan en met Christus te wees, want dit is verreweg die beste. Maar om in die vlees te bly is nodiger om julle ontwil. En dit vertrou en weet ek dat ek sal bly, ja, saam met julle almal sal bly tot julle bevordering en blydskap in die geloof, sodat julle roem oor my oorvloedig kan wees in Christus Jesus deur my teenwoordigheid weer by julle. I'd like to take out a few verses in Philippians 1 and emphasize a few verses. Verse 23. For I am pressed together by the two, having a desire to depart and to be with Christ, which is far better. And then he says, but to remain here, God still has a purpose for me, and maybe I can still mean something for someone. Maar ek wil die klem lê op wat Paulus hier sê. Filippense 1 vers 23, wat ek word van weerskante gedring, en ek het verlange om heen te gaan en met Christus te wees. Paulus wat sê, ek sien uit daarna die dag wanneer Christus besluit het dat ek hierdie lewe gaan verlaat. Met ander woorde, ek sien uit na die dood. Hy sê, ek word van twee kante af gedring of getrek. Daar's twee dinge wat my trek. Aan die een kant is dit hierdie verlange om dood te gaan en by Christus te wees, en aan die ander kant is daar weer die begeerte dat ek nog vir iemand iets kan beteken, dat ek nog siele kan inbring, dat ek die werk wat die Here my voor hier geroep het en gestuur het voor, nog kan volbring. And Paul is taking these two thoughts and he says, I'm pulled by these two thoughts. But if I should be honest, I have this longing, this desire to be with Christ. In simple words, I'm longing to die. I'm looking forward to the day when I will shut my eyes on earth and I will meet with my Lord. And by saying this, Paul is thinking of life. And he's thinking of the hardships. And he's thinking of what he had to go through and all the sufferings and persecutions. And he's thinking, it would be better for me. Wouldn't it be great if God decides that he'll take me from this earth and all the misery and everything I face on earth, and he takes me to heaven? Dink 'n bietjie daaraan, as een ek vanmôre moes kies, waar wil ek wees? Wil ek myself in 'n wêreld bevind vol hartseer en pyn en ongeregtigheid en onregverdige dinge wat gebeur, en al die goed rondom my gebeur wat ek nie verstaan nie, of wil ek eerder in die hemel wees, dan glo ek nie iemand sal anders wil kies nie. I don't believe that anyone would rather choose earth above heaven. And the only thing that Paul says would keep me here and is okay with me that I stay here is that God still has a purpose for me. But I've got a longing, Paul says. I've got a longing to be with Christ. And the question is, are you looking forward to dying? Sien jy uit om dood te gaan? In this context, we're talking about leaving earth. God taking me to Him in heaven and enjoying heaven, and we've got no idea what it means. The only thing we know is undescribable place God has prepared for you and for me. As ons vanmôre eerlik moet wees, dink ek sal elke kind van die Here hier in sy hart so 'n bietjie heimwee hê. Here, dit sal dan wonderlik wees as U vir my ook kan huis toe neem. But this longing of Paul, he could only have because certain things were in place. And this is what today's message is about. Paul in the first place had the surety in his heart that his life was settled and his sin was settled with God. His account was paid. He had the surety in his heart that he was forgiven. He would remind us in Scripture, in Acts, of the day when God confronted him. He heard the voice of God from heaven. And he describes his conversion. The day that Jesus called him, asked him to turn around. All the details not given to us, but we know it was a day where Paul came to Christ. Paulus se bekering wat vir ons in Handelinge beskryf word, vertel vir ons van die verhaal waar die Here met Paulus ernstig kom praat het, hom eintlik uit die hemel uit geroep het. Hy het 'n stem uit die hemel gehoor, Handelinge 9. En die detail word nie vir ons spesifiek gegee nie, maar ons weet hy daardie dag sy saak met Jesus reggemaak. Hy het daardie dag na die Here toe gekom. Hy moes daardie dag 'n besluit neem dat ek gaan omdraai. Ek gaan as 'n sondaar voor die Here kom buig. Ek gaan my sonde voor hom kom bely en neersit en vergifnis vind. En ons almal weet van daardie dag af was sy lewe nooit weer dieselfde nie. Wat Paulus daardie dag ontvang het, was die sekerheid dat hy kind van die Here is. Was die sekerheid dat sy sonde vergewe is. Was die sekerheid dat hy kind van God is en dat hy op pad is hemel toe. Want vir elkeen wat waarlik gered word, vir elkeen wat waarlik heelhartiglik omdraai en hom tot die Here bekeer en sy sondesaak uitmaak met die Here, ontvang sekerheid van saligheid. It is possible in this life. And I actually had people telling me it's impossible. It is possible to have the assurity of salvation in this life. In fact, I need to have the assurity. I need to know that I know that when God ends my life on earth, whenever it should be, whether it would be suddenly or whether it would be through sickness, but the day when God ends my life on earth, I must have the surety that I will go to heaven. This is why Paul could say, I'm looking forward to dying. Because dying for the child of God means I'm going out of this life to the next life. In Luke 16, we find Jesus is telling us a story of Lazarus and the rich man. And he explains to us what happens. On the one side, we hear the rich man that was not ready. And what happened to him? But on the other side, Lazarus, we read the moment when he closed his eyes, the moment he died, he was in paradise. Amazing, wonderful thought. Paul knows this. He was thinking of this. Wouldn't it be amazing if I should close my eyes on earth? And by the way, it happened quite several years after he wrote this. God still used him. But eventually, he was beheaded. And he knew that moment, I will be with Christ. This is why he's longing. This is why he's got this desire. He says, it would be far better for me. Who would not choose heaven above earth? Who would not choose being on Jesus' side with him in heaven? That's why he had this longing, but he had to have the assurity that he knew where he was going. And the sad of this life is, with religion and everything that is told for us and learned for us, it could be possible that I could have been misled. And I'm trying to build my salvation on something. There are people going around in this world, and in fact they stopped by lockdown, but going from house to house, bringing their false gospel to people because they want to go to heaven, because they want to be saved. There are so many people stuck in religion, doing religious exercises every day, thinking that if I do this, if I pray 5 times a day in a certain direction, I would go to heaven. Now, even in the Christian faith, so many people stuck in religion. People believing if I belong to a certain group or certain church, I'm included in the group that goes to heaven. Daar word soveel geleer en soveel vertel, en daar word soveel valse godsdienste versprei, dat daar soveel mense is wat probeer om in die hemel te kom volgens wat hulle geleer is. Ek dink een groot deel van ons samenleving sal glo dat as ek net baie godsdienstig is en ek gaan daar om kerk toe en dalk as ek gedoop is of dalk as ek gereeld Bybel lees, dalk as ek probeer goed doen aan mense en seker maak ek bring my kant en ek help wat ek kan, dat ek dalk in die hemel sal kan kom. Daar is selfs mense wat sê ek probeer om die hemel te verdien. Ek probeer my bes om goed genoeg te wees om in die hemel te kom. En die woord sê vir ons, Efesiërs 2 vers 8 en 9, ek word uit genade gered. Dit kan nie uit werke wees nie. Kan niks wees wat ek doen nie, ek sal nie daarop kan roem nie. Daar is absoluut niks wat u en ek kan doen om in die hemel te kom, behalwe om gebruik te maak van Christus Jesus se genade. There's only one way you and I can enter heaven. There's only one way of finding a surety of salvation, and that would be in Christ Jesus. God's word teaches us, I need to turn around. I need to accept him as my savior. I need to experience God in a personal way. And when Paul says, I'm longing for this day that I will be with Christ, he's actually telling us, I already know him. I've been walking this way for years with him. He's been speaking to me. He's been guiding me. He's been my personal friend. And I'm longing for the day when I will see him eye to eye. I'm longing for that day. He wouldn't just be in my heart, but I will see. Is dit nie ongelooflike dag om na u te sien? As ek in die lewe alreeds in 'n verhouding staan met Jesus en ek kan getuig dat ek hom ken. Hy praat met my, ek beleef hom. Hy is vir my 'n vriend, hy stap in hierdie lewe saam met my. Kan ons Paulus kwalik neem dat hy sê, ek sien uit na die dag wat ek hom in die oog gaan kyk. Ek sien so uit na die dag wat hy my sy hande gaan wys en daar gaan die merke wees. Omdat hy my gesterf het. Iets om na uit te sien vir die een wat sekerheid het. I don't think there would be a child of God not saying the same as Paul is telling us. Yes, there is reason for me to be here. And yes, I have family who need me. And yes, I have so much work still that can be done. And yes, there are so many people who still needs to hear the gospel, and God can use me. But by far, it would, be the best for me if I can be with Christ. Looking forward, actually, to the day I die. We need to mention the other side, because the other side is reality. What a fearful thought for anyone not having the surety. What a fearful thought for anyone struggling with the idea that around me, we believe very soon people will be dying. Around us, people are in lockdown. And imagine the possibility of dying alone somewhere, with no one around me, falling into darkness because I did not have the surety. There's no way someone can say, I'm looking forward to death, if I haven't got the surety, the blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. Daar's 'n ander kant van dood, en ons wil nie baie daarby stil staan nie, maar dis die werklikheid dat vir die meeste mense hou dood 'n verskrikking in. U sal in die hart weet wat gebeur as u dink aan dood. Wat gebeur in die hart as u dink dat u dalk binnekort tot sterwe kan kom? Wat gaan hierdie gedagtes as u dink u moet dalk alleen iewers sonder iemand rondom u hierdie verskriklike dood, donkerheid van dood, tegemoet gaan? Want Jesus is nog nie daar nie. I think and I believe this virus would cause so many people to start earnestly thinking about their life and their relationship with God. Religion will not help me. Trying to do my best will not help me. The only thing that will help me would be standing in a personal relationship with Jesus, and me knowing it this morning that He has saved me. It is Paul desiring, and this is not suicidal. This is not negative in any sense. This is just Paul telling us, what a wonderful day will it be if I can meet with Jesus. But it is Paul also telling us, for him, and we know that through history, there was still so much to do. It was to Timothy in 2 Timothy 4 verse 6, he writes that this life is like a race. And he tells Timothy, this was closer to his death, I'm reaching the finish line. I have completed the race. Paulus wat vir Timoteus persoonlik sê, hierdie lewe is 'n wedloop. 2 Timoteus 4. Hy sê, ek het hierdie wedloop volëindig. Ek het hom gehardloop tot die einde toe. And while Paul is longing to die, he realizes God can still have a purpose for me. There is still work to do. And he had no idea. He's sitting in jail, and anything could have happened. He's been tortured, and he was in the hands of the government, and anything could happen to him. But he realizes, even though I'm longing to die, God could still have purpose for me. And in fact, he says, I'm pulled by this side too, because I could have fruitful work still that I can do for God, for Jesus. And that was the fact. It did not get better. He didn't get a smoother ride. But he went further in life, working, doing what Jesus asked him to do. And in a way, Paul is telling us, I'm not selfish. if I'm longing to die. I just know, I just got this desire that it would be better being with Jesus. What is the answer if you should be asked, are you looking forward to death? If you hear on the news, people are dying around you, and we start experiencing it in South Africa, people are busy dying, maybe relatives, loved ones, because of a virus hitting the people. Is there longing in your heart? Is there assurance? Would it be okay? Can I say to God, if this is the way you want to take me, it would be wonderful, because I will be with you. And no matter what I should suffer, no matter what comes over my path, no matter what pain I would experience, Paul is the one speaking. He's been there. I know. I will be with Jesus. Ek het 'n verlange, sê Paulus, om heen te gaan. Maar terwyl daar nog werk is, wil ek my hande in die hande van my lewe in die hande van die Here sit. Ek wil vanmôre sê, Here, dankie dat ek die sekerheid kan hê. Dankie dat ek ook mag uitsien na die hemel. Dankie dat ek ook mag, as ek eerlik is, sê, Here, dit sal so lekker wees om by U te wees. Maar ek wil vanmôre met hierdie hele chaos wat heers, met al die onsekerheid, wil ek net opnuut my lewe in die hand kom sit en sê, Here, doen wat U wil. U kan doen enigiets. U kan toelaat wat U wil, wat ook al met my gebeur, hoe U vir my deur hierdie lewe en hierdie volgende paar weke wil vat, wat U met my wil maak. Ek wil my lewe kom sit in die hande en ek wil rustig raak. U weet wat U doen. Want as 'n kind van God is, dan beteken dit aan die einde. Wanneer dit ook al sal wees, dit kan oor 30 jaar wees, dit kan oor 2 weke wees, dit kan oor 5 jaar wees, wanneer dit ook al gebeur, gaan ek by die Here wees. Maar aan die ander kant wil ek vanmôre vra, as die Here iets in hierdie wêreld toelaat wat vir ons net so 'n bietjie skud, wat vir ons letterlik tot stilstand bring, wat vir ons op so 'n harde manier die werklikheid van die dood kom wys. En miskien is dit nog nie so werklik nie, want ons beleef dit nog nie om ons nie. Kom ons sit onsself in Italië en hulle omstandighede. En dit het te veel geraak, ons weet nie eens meer hoeveel nie, ons weet nie eens meer wie hulle almal is nie, maar rondom ons weet ons in hulle hoop is geliefdes en vriende besig om te sterf. En een, ek is vanmôre in daardie omstandighede, is dit rustig in die hart. Have you got the peace this morning? If you and I should find ourselves in Italy or in Spain, where this horrific circumstances is busy killing so many people, bringing so much misery, causing so much pain, and around us people are dying. Does it bring a longing? Does it bring a longing to go home to Jesus? Or does it cause fear? And the invite this morning is, if it causes fear, if there's no assurity, this is where God's word steps in. This is where Jesus steps in. And if you hear Him calling, if you hear Him talking to you, if you realize you're actually lost on the wrong way, you're not condemned in the right place, what better time, in times like trouble we find ourselves, to turn to God. It is my prayer, and this is a prayer I will join anytime, praying that God will show His mercy to millions, billions of people. That God would talk to people, that people would hear His voice, that people would turn to Jesus for salvation in numbers, getting saved, so that they could also long, like Paul, to the day they should die. What is the answer? Are you longing to die? Not because anything else, but because it would be a day you would be with Jesus? Or is there fear in your heart? May God help. Amen. Come, let us pray together. Lord, we thank you for bringing us salvation. Jesus, thank you for paying the price so that each person, any person, can find salvation. Jesus, dank je dat u voor die wereld komt sterven. En ik bid voor een wereld, Heere, wat in chaos is. Ik bid voor een mensdom, Heere, wat in soveel gevallen, in benauwdheid, eindelijk maar net sit en wacht om dood te gaan. En die verschrikking van het dood zonder u tegemoet moet gaan. Bid ons voor groot genade. Heere, ik bid dat saaikies wat gesaai is in harte, waar mensen van u gehoor het, sal vrug dra. Ek bid, Heere, dat die mense na die woord toe sal dryf. Ek bid dat hulle wat benauwd is, wat in omstandighede is waar mense rondom hulle sterf, na die woord toe sal vlug en dat hierdie tyd sal wees waar mense die tyd sal hê om tyd vir u te maak, tyd te maak met die woord en by u sal uitkom. Ek bid vir die kinders, Heere, ek bid vir ons gemeente, Heere, dat dit 'n tyd sal wees wat ons na die tyd vir mekaar sal sê, dit was wonderlik. Want ons het nader aan Jesus gekom. Dit was wonderlik, want ons het tyd gehad om in gebed met Jesus te spandeer. Ons het tyd gehad om meer van die woord te bestudeer. Gee dat ons alles wat anders ons anders sal wegtrek, wat die vijand voor ons sal neersit. Enig iets anders, Heere, wat vir ons sal, van ons van u sal wegtrek, help vir ons om het neer te sit en om in hierdie tyd vir u te soek, die tyd uit te koop en aan ons verhouding met u te werk. Ons bid dit in Jesus naam. Amen. Ons het nou die dag op Tannie Rosie se roudiens het die lied gesing wat haar gunsteling lied was, en ek wil dit weer vanmorgen sing. And I know there are some of you who attended the service of Tannie Rosie, and you will be reminded of this song that was her favorite song. Oh, please let me walk with you, Jesus, don't ever leave me alone. I think it's very appropriate for the times we find ourselves in, to ask the Lord that we would walk with him. Please excuse me as I step out of the line. We're going to conclude with this song, and then I'll pray, and then we'll finish. Jesus Christus, die liefde van God die Vader en die gemeenskap van God die Heilige Gees met ons elkeen wees en bly. Amen.